We identified significant inaccuracies and omissions in each of the four applications, 7 in the first application and a total of 17 by the final renewal application. Department lawyers and the court should have been given complete and accurate information so they could have meaningfully evaluated probable cause before authorizing the surveillance of a U.S. person associated with a presidential campaign.
Hours in now. Andy, your thoughts?
Watching this and having worked for a very long time in a federal prosecutor's office, I have to confess I'm stunned by the impression conveyed that this could have been 5 people having conversations and nobody else knows anything about anything. Let's remember what we're talking about here. They were going to court under oath and telling the court they had probable cause to believe that the Trump campaign could be in a cyber espionage conspiracy with a hostile foreign power, the Kremlin. And the thought that there were only 5 people who were in on that and that nobody else knew about it, and, you know, the poor Justice Department lawyers, the poor higher-ups at the FBI, the idea that people are not asking questions and making sure that before we put allegations in a complaint or in an affidavit that is going to make that kind of allegation is just absurd to me. It would never have happened. I happen to have worked for a long time in the same office that Mike Horowitz did, the Southern District of New York. That would never have happened there. And the thought that...
So you're just not buying this, Andy.
I'm not... Look, I'm having this outer body experience the whole day, especially the conversation about whether, you know, whether bias motivated this or not. I kind of feel like I feel when there's an Islamic or a jihadist terrorist attack where, you know, the evidence is neon blinking and we sit around saying we may never know what the motive was. I mean, really?
Which is the question Leahy asked toward the end, the question of bias, did it impact their work? And Horowitz would not affirm that suggestion.
Well, but Bill, here's what he says. He says bias didn't appear to affect the opening of the investigation, which he's able to say because the standards for opening the investigation are so low as to be illusory. And then he says when we get to the FISAs, that's where it becomes more difficult to assess. And I, as I listen to him say that, I must say, if you were trying cases to Justice Department lawyers instead of common sense juries, no one would ever be convicted. Because what he continues to say again and again is, we did not get documentary or testimonial evidence that bias caused the irregularities, which is a lawyered way of saying there's no document and there's no testimony that they drew from someone who said, yes, there was bias. Yes, I was biased. Yes, I saw bias. But when you prove bias in a courtroom, you do it on the basis of common sense inference from what people say and what they do. You don't rely on someone to say, I'm biased. It's just not the way
it's a fascinating evaluation.